The nutrition problem has different aspects, including obesity, malnutrition, dietary and food quality, food distribution, nutrition education, and awareness. Malnutrition and obesity are different sides of one problem. When advanced countries are suffering from obesity, underdeveloped countries are lost by malnutrition. Both these problems have their regularity and history.
Penso che sia dovuto principalmente al fatto che nei paesi industrializzati non si mangia più per nutrirsi, ma si mangia per piacere e si mangia cose che non fanno bene alla salute, mentre nei paesi sottosviluppati non c'è proprio il cibo.
Mi sembra evidente la sproporzione tra queste due cifre. Non sono necessari commenti, nel senso che tutti possono comprendere da soli che non c'è equilibrio tra le parti, ecco.
A generous portion of American fast food, instead of fruit and vegetables, generate high obesity rates across the planet. According to OECD Obesity Update, the highest obesity rates are in the USA, Mexico, Australia, UK, and Canada. In the USA, obesity rates have reached high record, and physicians have officially classified it as a disease. 31.8% of US adults are now considered clinically obese. America's obesity problem has a significant impact on children and adolescents. Habits formed during childhood and adolescence usually persist into adulthood, making overweight children and adolescents more likely to become overweight adults. South African countries face another problem. According to UNICEF, malnutrition is a major underlying cause of death in 64% of children under the age of 5 in South Africa.
Penso sia dovuto anche al fatto che comunque non ci siano le conoscenze adatte e opportune. Comunque nutrirsi bene non significa mangiare qualsiasi cosa, significa mangiare ciò che fa bene alla salute in quantità moderate.
A lack of education is also another cause of malnutrition. It is very important to explain that if healthy food is more expensive than takeaway, you can simply start gardening, which would save a big part of the budget. Voice of America writes in its recent report that Oxfam recommends South Africa's government to introduce a National Food Act in order to eradicate hunger and malnutrition. Many efforts have been done to save Africa from malnutrition. Key vitamins and minerals have been added to wheat flour, maize flour, and retail sugar in accordance with mandatory regulations that came into effect in 2003. Salt for human consumption is also iodized. A huge work in the field of educating people about eating culture and nutrition problems is done in UNESCO in the framework of Nutrition Education Series, which contains the roles of educational institutes on different levels as well as community participation in nutrition education, the program FRESH, focusing resources on effective school health, which is starting the point for developing an effective school health, hygiene, and nutrition program, and making education a priority in post-2015 development agenda, where nutrition education is emphasized.